Hey guys, Top Hops here. There were some shopping carts going in the background, but we are going to see the brand new movie, The Suicide Squad. But before we go over there, we definitely have to get some snacks. So let's go in here and grab some good stuff. Oh, and also, let's get started. All right, guys, so I came over to the candy section to get something. The question is what? Oh, I do like these guys. Not a sponsor, but these ones right here are the Dairy Milk Marvelous Mix. It's a mix of both Maynards and chocolate. I mean, it's pretty much the best of both worlds. And oh, guys, before we get out of here, they do have Pops, so we might as well check. And I doubt they're going to have any of the Suicide Squad figures. Yeah, it doesn't look like it. So anyways, let's just go to the movies. All right, everybody. So we are now in our seats. We've got Noah and Emily here as well. And I just want to let you guys know that we are the only ones in the theater. So this might be a movie to ourselves. Pretty exciting.
And look at the reclining seats.
Oh, yeah, they do have reclining seats as well. Pretty snazzy. But anyways, guys, I can't show you any of the movies. So let's just sit down and I'll see you guys at the end.
Ratatouille, what do you got?
Bird.
Now it. Stay off the comp.
All right, guys, well, we are now out of the movie, and before we go back to the office, we might as well check over at EB Games to see if there's any Pops that I'm missing from the set. All right, guys, I'm doing some digging around back here in the section, and I don't see very many of the Suicide Squad Pops. I think the only one that they have is Bloodsport, but the day after, they do have a couple of the ones from Funcon, like the Squirtle, Belly Dancer, Homer, actually one left of him, and then a couple of these ones over here, and actually in my video yesterday, I talked about this one, and I knew that this one was gonna be here for a while. So I guess I don't need to get anything over here at EB Games, so let's just go back to the office and check out all of the figures that I already have for the set. All right, everybody, so it is late at night, but we are done the film, and I seriously really enjoyed this. And now, dare I say, this is one of my favorite superhero films that I've seen in a long time. Like, my favorite one that I had seen before this was either probably Infinity War or Endgame. Like, seriously, this movie is in my top three for superhero films anyways. And so, guys, now that we're back and I've actually seen the film, I'm gonna be going through all of the Suicide Squad Funko Pops that I have in my collection, then I'm gonna be kind of talking about them and how they fit into the movie. So, like I said at the beginning, there's gonna be spoilers, so just be warned. And I guess, guys, we'll start with this one right here, which is Bloodsport, played by Idris Elba. Now, I really do enjoy this figure, and it looks a lot creepier in the pop than I thought it was going to be, because seriously, that mouth, I mean, you don't see it that close up, but it looks almost like a skull when really it's just the mask that he wears over top, and it kind of comes apart in two pieces. Really neat, though. And I would say out of all of the different Suicide Squad Pops that came out, I would say this one's probably one of the most mediocre. Like, I mean, he doesn't really have much going on. He's kind of just standing there in a pose where his arms are to the sides. It's kind of like that classic Funko Pop feel that I always talk about, where it's really just like big head, arms to the sides, and then that's about it. But I mean, you still get to see all of the great detail in his suit, so I think that's what Funko was going for, still making it a great pop. And then, guys, after Bloodsport, let's get on to this one right here, which is the Polka Dot Man. Now, this one is probably one of the most colorful out of all of them, especially because he's got polka dots all over his suit. I mean, it makes sense. And now, I did buy this one the other day saying that I thought that he was going to be funny in the movie, when actually, he was kind of a weird character. He was probably one of the darkest, I would say, out of all of them, especially because of what he said throughout the film. But then he did seem to be a really nice guy in the end. Just towards the beginning, he really didn't seem like he enjoyed himself or what he was doing. Like, it was really odd, but I still enjoyed the character. And I will say, he definitely wasn't this dark in the Lego Batman movie. But then again, this one was rated R when that one's PG, so it totally makes sense. And now, I definitely want to pop this figure out of the box just to show you guys the entire figure, because you don't get to see all of the details that you would see just inside the box. So if you guys were to see him here, he is on one knee, which I think is a really neat addition to this figure. And then also on the back side here, you can see all of the different polka dots all over him. And now the one thing that I wish Funko would have changed about this pop is the way they did his hand, and now he's shooting out the polka dots. But I mean, it's not really their fault. It's hard to make it look like something's actually coming out of his hand. But the one thing that I would have changed is maybe made it orange, almost like fire, because all of the polka dots do catch on fire throughout the film. And now, guys, next up, let's talk about this one right here, which is TDK, or the Detachable Kid. Now, this one, I was totally confused about when I saw it, but I'm so glad that I did get it during our Funcon Pop Hunt. And now, after watching the film, I totally understand why they made TDK a Summer Conventions exclusive, because you think that you're gonna be following these guys the entire time, but they are literally the real Suicide Squad, and I mean, like, literally Suicide Squad, and then we follow these guys just a little bit after, and it really is cool how they make the transition. And speaking of transitions, I really did enjoy how James Gunn did it throughout the film, and I'm guessing this was something that he probably wanted in the film. I loved how they did every single transition going like forwards and backwards in time. It really was neat, especially when the time popped up on the screen in all of these weird ways. But now, guys, let's pop TDK out of the box, and I really want to see the way he's got his arm off there, as well as if there's any other parts that are detached. Like, I don't think there is. No, there's not. But having his arm off like that is definitely interesting, and it would be cool if they made him so both of his arms were off, but I think this was probably the best way to do it, where it was still all attached as one big figure. And I feel like because his boots are muddy, this is from the scene where he's on the beach. Well, actually, no, it's definitely from that, because this is the only scene where his arms are detached. Like, they actually fly across to try to defeat the military coming at them. And I love that he kept his name a secret as well, because the TDK is way more menacing than the detachable kid. Like, if I had that name, I'd probably keep it secret as well. And now, guys, I have one more figure in my collection, which is this one right here. And this figure has actually been really hard to find. This one here is King Shark, and I'm so glad that I could grab this one before I saw the film. And I'm so glad that I got this one before the film came out, because I feel like a lot of people are going to want to get the King Shark, because he was kind of like the butt of the joke for all of them. I mean, he was the comic relief in the film. And now this one I definitely have to pop out of the box as well, because I really enjoy this figure, and especially how Funko did it. Because they added him in his human disguise, and I don't know if you guys can tell, those shorts are him trying to be a human, and him waving is also kind of like, hello, I don't know. And something about it really makes him seem like he's trying to be a human in this figure, and that's what he was doing with those shorts on in the film. And if I were to guess, that hand is probably from him at the beginning of the film when he looks at his hand and goes, hand? It's gotta be that. Now, the one thing that I wish that Funko did a little bit differently about this figure is if they actually took his hand and put it right here like it was a mustache, because he is wearing the human shorts and he wouldn't technically be wearing him when he does the hand thing. So I think it would have been cool if he put the finger right up to his face to almost be like he's pretending to be a human in this exact figure. So I don't know, Funko, just an idea, but if you want to make another one in the future, I would love to see one of either a bloody version of this or, like I said, the one with the mustache, because I think both would be really great. And actually, speaking of other figures that I think Funko could make, they could definitely make two more for these ones right here. Polka Dot Man, I would definitely love to see a glow-in-the-dark version, or maybe a bumpier version of him that is also glow-in-the-dark. And then for Bloodsport, I mean, an unmasked version would be great. And now, because I don't have all of the figures in my collection, we might as well check out the back of the box so you guys can see the other ones, with the Harley Quinn Bloodsport Pacemaker Harley Quinn, again in dress, which is what she wears for most of the film, so I'm glad that they made two versions of her. Then we also have Polka Dot Man, we've got the Ratcatcher 2 with Sebastian. Now, that one is definitely a figure that I want to get, but the funny part is that I actually haven't seen that one in stores anywhere, but now that I've seen the film, I definitely want to get her. And then we also, of course, have King Shark and Rick Flag, and all of these really do look great. And now that I'm looking at the back of the box, I feel like the one that is the most boring out of all of them is probably Rick Flag. Like, he's very similar to Bloodsport, where they're just kind of in like a power pose like this, and there's not much going on. Actually, now that I think about it, they could do another version of Bloodsport where he's unmasked, but then also has a giant gun like he has at the end of the film. That would be a really neat figure. And now, if any of you guys are wondering if I recommend this movie, and I would definitely say I would, because it was a great film, and it was about a 2.5 hour movie, and there was really no lulls throughout the film. Like, the entire thing was action-packed, and I really did enjoy that. And Funko, if you're watching, I would love to see so many more figures from this film, like Starfish, as well as that guy at the end, I can't remember his name, where he has a bunch of like things stuck in his head. He'd be pretty cool. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you guys want to see more from me in the future, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, do all that. But this has been another episode of Top Ops. Popsters, thanks for watching. See you guys tomorrow. Whoa, I'm a big bag hunter with the bow. She got a big bed, number drop low. Mama called me and she happy with the grow. Never ever fall for a party that's a no. Just bought the Kenny, about a million options. So just talking to stop doing the gleaming. I'm rock green, is bringing the peace. I'm bumping that park in the car, pretending I got all the eyes on me. Got a bad baby and she's independent.